Let's take a look at topics in Copilot Studio, what they are, how to use them, and why they're important. This video is part of my Copilot Studio Essentials series, where we cover all of the major skills in under 10 minutes. Topics allow you to control the flow of the conversation. You do not want generative AI just answering everything all the time. It's fantastic, but think about those scenarios where you might have something that is very regulated or has legal implications, safety implications, or just for your brand, you want the Copilot to answer a certain way. So topics allow you to do those things, and you want to use topics and knowledge together. These are both things, but understand how to use both of them for a really good experience. So we're going to go into the topic section of the Copilot here. You'll see that we've got both custom topics and system topics. Custom topics are the ones that you're going to use to create your own conversational experience. System topics are all the things that just makes the Copilot function, including things like being able to get user feedback and handling errors. One of them that I want to draw your attention to while we're here, though, is this conversation start topic, because this is what happens when the Copilot first greets the user. You'll notice that this is a little bit maker-facing as a starting point. It says, hello, I'm bot name, that's all good. I'm a virtual assistant. Good practice to do that. But this second part here, if you provided a website, try asking me about it. This is sort of giving you instructions as a user and isn't something that you want to have facing. So what we're going to do here is just remove that second part. You can add something in here. I can help you stay healthy. And you can even add a little emoji if you like. I'm using the Windows and period key there to bring up my emoji keyboard. So you can give it a little bit of personality. Trick here, click outside of that and then click the save button. And now your Copilot will greet the user with that new message. And you have done your first topic. Let's refresh the test Copilot here just so that you can see that in action. If we go back to the topics menu here, we have the button here to add a topic, and you can either create this from blank or you can create it from a description. So what we're going to do here in our healthy advisor Copilot is provide a topic that is about people who might be asking about mental health services. And rather than it just giving a generic answer, we actually want to give the user options that are conditional branching based on different things. So you can come in here. So let's call this one mental health services. And then we are going to create a topic to provide information about mental health services for different age groups. I've asked it to provide multiple choice options. Now you can be very general here or very descriptive in how you want that topic to work. The more descriptive you are, the more control you've got over the layout of it. But you'll see as we go in here, you can make changes as you go along. So it tells you what it's done. It's repeated my prompt and it's added all of these different things in. Let's take a look at that. We'll just close that down. You can actually use that to edit the Copilot as well. And we'll close the test canvas down here as well, just to give me a bit more room, and we'll zoom up. So the first thing we've got is a series of trigger phrases. This is what determines the intent. So when the user types something in, it's going to use this to understand when to trigger this topic. We're going to change a setting to use something more clever with generative AI in a minute to come back to that. It first asks a question. So what age group are you in? I asked it to provide me with multiple choice options and it's done that. And then it's going to save the user response as a variable. So it understands to keep that piece of information and then to use it later. What we've then got is a series of conditions. If it's equal to this, then that, and then an option for anything that doesn't fit that. And it's actually even come up with its own messages in here. And obviously for my particular Copilot, I would want to control what's in those messages. Let's bring the test canvas back here and just prompt this one and say, I want mental health services. And you'll see that now what it's doing, this Copilot is also connected to a website that has information about that. But because I've taken control of the conversation here, it's coming through and providing these options. So I want something for children. And then it's gone through with that answer. Let's upgrade the experience here. We're going to come into settings. Oh, before we do that, make sure you save that topic. Always good to save it. Let's come into the settings now and go into the generative AI settings. And what we want to do is say, instead of this classic experience, which is these trigger phrases, which is 5 or 6 different trigger phrases, I actually want to use this generative piece, which at the time of recording is preview, but this is definitely the better experience and the future state that you want to be working with, and then close the settings down. What happens now is that my topic trigger phrases have been converted into a description. So this means that the description is what's going to be used by the large language model to determine the path of this. And as you create other topics now, you'll just give them a script description rather than having to use trigger phrases, which is a much more sophisticated way of doing it. Let's take a look at another topic if we were building this from scratch. So if we come back into topics and let's create a topic from blank so that you just get the sense of the canvas, you can come in here and add that description of what the topic does. And then you can do all of these different things. You can choose to send a message. So this could be a very simple, just if someone triggers this thing, send the message. More typically, what you would do here is start by asking a question, which is the thing that we just had. So then we've got the question of, you know, what age group do you need a service for? And then you can choose to identify from that question all sorts of different pieces of information. So you can just be looking at information from the response, or you can be using those multiple choice options or other different pieces of information. These are called entities that it can extract from the conversation. From there, we can send a message. You can add conditions. So this is the conditional branching that we had earlier. You can also do other things like add an adaptive card if you've got that skill set. Or if you don't have that, one of my favorite things to do in the message here is just to add a basic card, which is a very quick and easy way to say you can just put in a title, a subtitle, an image URL, and a text, and that will give you something that looks like this, that is a very easy thing to create without needing any code. You've also got the options in here to call an action, which allows your bot to do something, to call a flow or to call some other system to gather information or to post information to other systems. I'll see you in the next video to learn more about actions.